凶狠。
Is he stuck with?
I did too.
What did you?
I would take Victoria Martis any day.
That's a beautiful
وتفعلنا بها على الدرجات وتبلغنا بأقصى الغايات من جميع خير أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله حمد الحق الحمد لله الذي جعل الدنيا حياة زوال وفناء الحمد لله الذي جعل الآخرة دار خلود وبقاء سبحانه ما حمدناه حق حمده وما أثنينا عليه حق الثناء نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونسترشده ونستعطيه ونعوذ به سبحانه من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له إلا الله سبحانه وتعالى أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقراراً بربوبيته وإلغاماً بمن جحد به وكفر وأشهد أن محمداً عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من بين خلقه وخليله الذي بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة سيدا للخلق والبشر صلوات الله وسلامه عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وصحبك الطيبين الطائعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان واقتفى آثارهم وخطى خطاهم وعلينا معهم إلى يوم الدين عباد الله اتقوا الله All the servants of Allah fear and show taqwa before Allah abide by his order in his book يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته All you who believe fear Allah the way he deserves to be feared and die not except in a state of Islam يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد All you who believe fear Allah and let each nafs Look forward. What has it done for tomorrow? إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ For Allah Ta'ala is most knowing of that which you are doing. Ibadallah, if I was to pass a question on to you and say, what is the ultimate the truth that each and every one of us is going to experience? Collectively, I am sure the answer will be death. And if I add another question about the second most definite truth that we are going to experience, no doubt the answer that I'm gonna hear is life after death. The resurrection, the qiyamah. To us mu'mins, to us believers, this is a pillar of our iman. That we must believe in Allah, the angels, the books, we must believe in the messengers, we must believe that the death is haqq, we must believe that the yawm al-akhir is also haqq. But perhaps the second truth is an obstacle for many. For the disbelievers, they don't want to even think that there is a yawm al-akhir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, based on our pillars of Islam, says, ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبْعَثُونَ. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after addressing the stages of the creation, He says, then after that, you will die. And then after that, you will be brought back up again. For those who disbelieve, they don't want that part. They're happy with the part that they're alive. But for those who, non-Muslims, but have faith, and they believe that there is a superpower, and they believe there is a creation, and they might say that there is a day of judgment, however, they draft it in a picture that they like and that they accept for themselves. Just like was the story in Surah Al-Kahf about the two people, who one was rich and one was poor. The rich one walks into his Jannah. He says, this is not going to go. And if it's gone, I'm going to find better one than this in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, in almost every surah, hundreds of ayats, emphasizes on the meaning that there is going to be a ba'th. We are gonna be brought up again. He says, Ya ayyuhan nas, addressing mankind, because all mankind, when it comes to ba'th, are equal, they're all coming. Ya ayyuhan nas, inna wa'ad Allahi haqq, that the promise of Allah Ta'ala is most true. It's haqq. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. And who is more truthful? And which saying is more truthful than the saying of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? In Surah Al-An'am, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, قُلْ لِمَنْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. O Muhammad, say, to whom does that which is in the samawat and earth belongs? Say to Allah, قُلْ لِلَّهِ كَتَبَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. He wrote upon himself mercy. لَيَجْمَعَنَّكُمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. That he will gather you, that he will gather thee into the day of judgment. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. No doubt. الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But those who are in total loss do not believe. Once these meanings truly get digested in the heart of the believer, he knows and he will realize that this dunya is on the go to the null. it is going to nothing. That this dunya is worth zero. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this dunya is not worth to Allah the wing of a mosquito. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha al-nas, la taghurrannakum al-hayatu al-dunya. Do not get intimidated by this dunya. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And do not get deceived by the deceiver. الغرور. Another ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, addresses it as الغرور. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. And that the hayat al-dunya is nothing but tools of deceiving. Al-gharur, scholar says, is a shaitan. His name is the deceivers. He is the deceiver. And his tools are called al-gharur. They are the tools of deceiving. Do not let this shaitan deceive you. Only a few months ago, 2 months ago, I was looking at the garden. It was all beautiful. It had flowers. They were yellow and they were purple and violet. They were beautiful. And now when I pass by, I look at it and they're like hashed up. They're dry. They're nothing. And when I look at it, I say, this is al-hayat al-dunya. Isn't this a hayat al-dunya? In the plant world, this is hayat al-dunya. And the examples in the Quran, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا. The example of the life of this dunya is just like a water falls down and then all the plants gets all mixed up and it gets muddy and hashed up and it will go and gets all washed up again. Blessed is he who realizes and reminds himself and continuously keep that thought in his head that this dunya is about and is going to leave. And this dunya is going to end. And he keeps his heart attached with the afterworld. It's called dunya. It is called dunya. From dunu. The word dunya in Arabic means dunu, which is beneath. It's lower, it's beneath. It is also called al-ajila, the quick one, the fast one. It is called al-ula, the first one, which immediately you think, is there a second one? It is called al-akhira. It is called al-ajila, the later one. The later one, we say the better ones for later. We save the best for last. It is the later one, al-akhirah. It is always attached by this word, which I love. It's called ad-darul akhirah. Ad-dar. In the Arab world, the word dar is used for joy, for gathering. It's like the great room of the akhirah. Ad-darul akhirah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, Allahumma la aish illa aish al-akhirah. Oh Allah, the true living is the living of the akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses as hayat al-dunya, hayat, which means there must be death. But the akhirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not say al-hayat al-akhirah, because there's no death. He says ad-dar al-akhirah. And our Prophet, when he said, Allahumma la aish illa aish al-akhirah, he said it in two positions, in two situations. The first one, when he was doing the trench around the Medina, when the Ahzab was coming to fight him, where all the Ashab were in a devastated state. Everybody was going through fear. And the Prophet Muhammad said, Allahumma sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you know who is the stingy? The stingy who? Prophet Muhammad says, he hears my name and does not say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. He said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة. While they were digging the trench, when they were in a state of fear, and when he was in حجة الوداع, and he was, they were making with all 10,000, 50,000, 100,000 people making حجة الوداع in a state of victory and strength. He said, اللهم لا عيش, عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said, اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة. And the أصحاب الكرام realized this and took the means and achieved the goal. The goal is الآخرة. In Surah Al-Qasas, a key ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهِ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. And seek with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given you, الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. This is the ultimate goal for a mu'min. It is the most optimum thing that he needs to look for. It is الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. Must invest everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given him in the da'a for the sake of achieving all these ni'ams that we have, all these graces, the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given and bestowed upon us should be directed, should be a tool to help us achieve the good state of the akhirah. ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا. Seek وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار الآخرة ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا. And do not forget your share of this dunya. Do not forget your share. قتادة التابعي, he says, the نصيب, the share of the mu'min in this dunya from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him is everything that is halal. You want to have a big house? You can have a big house. You want to have a beautiful car? You can have a beautiful car. As long as it is halal for you. You want to have this, you want to have that. But invest it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to have children? Invest them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Teach them the Quran. Teach them the religion. Make them ashab da'wah. You want to have knowledge? That's fine. You want to become a doctor? Fine. Invest it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to have money? That is fine. Use it in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as it is halal, you can have. But we reach a time that we turn the means into a goal, and the true goal is way behind us. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Abu Ubaidah came from Al-Bahrain, he came from the Bahrain with a lot of money. The people of Medina came over to the masjid to see, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled and he said, I guess you all know that Abu Ubaidah brought with him a lot of money. They all said, yes, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He replied, Wallahi. Wallahi, man faqra akhsha alayk. That I am not afraid that you are poor. I'm not afraid that you are in a poverty at all. But I am afraid that this dunya will open up its gate onto you. And then you make it your goal. فَتَنَافَسُوهَا. You will compete in it for the sake, not the sake of akhirah, for the sake of the dunya. You compete in it so you can get more. فَتَنَافَسُوهَا. Just like the nations before you. كَمَا تَنَافَسُوهَا. Just like they did. فَأَهْلَ فَتُهْلِكَكُمْ. And it will destroy you. Just like it destroyed them. Baba many times said to this money, keep it in your hand. Never for it to make its way to your heart. Never. Keep it in your hands. Never. We live to spend, yes. We live to spend as long as it's in a way that pleases Allah. We make it to spend it, yes. But we do not live to make it. We do not live because it actually does not belong to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this risk. As Brother Muhammad always says, rizquka is your risk, even if it's under the jabal. It's gonna get to you if it's under the mountain. It's coming to you. It's not yours, actually. It's actually not your effort. It might sound. And how many of us worked hard and made little? And how many of us worked little and made a lot? It will come to you regardless. But we get carried away and we make it our goal and we seek it day and night and we forget the real cause. And time is clicking. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Take advantage of five before five. And I'm sure you know what those fives are. Take advantage of your youth before you're old. Don't say, I'm going to go to Hajj inshallah when I get older. And take advantage of your health before you're sick. You don't want to say, Allah, I am sick and I cannot fast. What have you done when you were strong, when you were healthy? Take advantage of your wealth, of your richness before you're poor. And take advantage of your spare time before you get busy and have no time. I see many youth who spend their life chasing life and they say, we still have time. Wallahi, you don't have time. If you ask your fathers and the elderly, you don't have time. Time goes so quick. It just invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your time, your effort, your money. Investors who knows and they know about economics and they know about 2% and the 3% and the 4%, they better off knowing that the investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can gain them up to 700%, 700 times. And that's in everything you do, not just financials. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in anything you do up to 700 times. من الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا. Who is he who would give Allah a loan? A good loan. The people of this book, they said, Allah is poor, he wants a qard. But this qard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you back up to 700 times. As long as we keep on our eyes in front of us, in our hearts, that this dunya is just a means. Use all these gifts that Allah give you to earn the greater gifts. And act like you are always on the go. This is your real place. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you shall return. To return, which means that is the actual place. This place is a place of agony. When Allah created Adam alayhi salam, he said to him in Jannah, وَإِنَّ لَكَ أَلَّا تَجُوعَ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْرَى. You will not be hungry in it. You will not be naked in it. وَأَنَّكَ لَا تَظْمَأُ فِيهَا وَلَا تَضْحَى. and you will not be thirsty in it, and you will not be hot and sweaty in it. But in this dunya, we know what these things mean. In the Jannah, you will not get tired. In this dunya, ayyuhal insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal insan, O man, innaka kadhun ila rabbika. Kadhan, you are going to be struggling your way all the way to Allah until you meet Him. So meet Him while He is pleased with you. And meet Him, and in your heart that this dunya, Prophet Muhammad says, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ. Live this dunya as if you are a stranger. أَوْ عَابِرِ سَبِيلٌ, or a passing by person. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am in this dunya is not but like a traveler who passed by, rested under the shade of a tree, and he continued on. When the angel of death came and asked Adam, asked Nuh alayhi salam, he asked him, Oh Nuh, the longest living prophet on earth, 950 years. How do you describe dunya? He said, I describe it like a house. I went in from the door and I went out from the other door. Oh Allah, do not make us among those who say, رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْأَخْرَةِ مِنْ خَلَقٍ. Allahumma, don't make us amongst those who say, Oh Allah, grant us in this dunya, and doesn't even think of the akhirah. But Allah, make us amongst those who says, رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Allahumma, أَمِينَ. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. It's all by the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He guides us today, He guides us tomorrow, He guides us inshaAllah in the future. And He guided the well-doing ones in the past. Ashab al-Kiram subhanahu wa ta'ala was God, they were guided. They were guided. They used the means of the Prophet away. This is hikmah, is when you use whatever you have properly in the right time, in the right place. It is called hikmah. وَمَنْ أُوْتِيَ الْحِكْمَةِ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. He who has given wisdom, he has given a bundle. He has given plenty. Ashab al-Kiram, take the most great ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given them. Gave them the ni'mah of iman. And I was discussing this with a dear brother that we always talk. He took this, they took this, and they went all over the world with it. Ashab al-Kiram did not stay in Medina. Wallahi, they did not. They took it. One is dead, died. Abu Ayyub al-Ansari is in Turkey. Abu Huraira, who the narrator of Hadith, radiallahu anhu majma'in, is in Sham. Khalid bin Walid is in Homs. Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas, he has a maqam in China. They knew that they were not to just take iman. This is a blessing from Allah. And save it for themselves. And stay in content. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, I make my prayer in this masjid and I am... No. They knew their purpose. And we need to follow their path. They are our example. And if we follow their path, inshaAllah rabbil alameen, we will be with them in Jannah, inshaAllah. Allahumma alameen. Allahumma laka alhamdu hamdan yuwafi ni'amak. Wa yukafi masidak. Wa yadfa'u niqamak. Wa yajlubu ata'ak. Wa yuhakku rahmatak. ويستوجب مغفرتك. ربنا لا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك فنهلك ونكن من الخاسرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همي ولا مبلغ علمي. اللهم يا ربنا واجعل الآخرة قصدنا ومنالنا يا أرحم الراحمين. حبب إلينا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب نبيك وحب الآخرة وحب كل عمل وكل شيء يقربنا إلى حبك يا أرحم الراحمين. صلي وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم فرج عن هذه الأمة ما نزل بها من كرب عظيم، فرج عن أمة محمد ما نزل بها من كرب عظيم. اللهم لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا، اللهم لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا، اللهم وجازنا واحكم علينا بما هم خيارنا يا أرحم الراحمين. شفعهم فينا يا حي يا قيوم. انظر إلى أهلنا في سوريا وفي إلى أهلنا في اليمن وفي تركيا وفي باكستان وفي بورما وفي الصين وفي مشارق الأرض ومغاربها بعين الرحمة والرفق والعون. فرج عن أهلنا في العراق وغزة يا حي يا قيوم. آمين آمين آمين. وصلي وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وخاتم أعواننا في الله رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن قارون كان من قوم موسى فبغى عليهم وآتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة إذ قال له قومه لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك ولا تبغ الفساد في الأرض إن الله لا يحب سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله
أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله، إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم، أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.